Students, let's continue with number system. In previous videos, we discussed what is number system and its types. So there are four types of number system: binary number system, decimal number system, octal number system, and hexadecimal number system. So out of these four types, we have discussed first three types, and only one type is left, that is hexadecimal number system. Now let's see the next slide. Types of number system. So just now we discussed four type: decimal, binary, octal, and hexadecimal number system. Now come to the hexadecimal number system. Now the base of hexadecimal number system is 16, and in this number system we use the digits 0 to 15. It uses alphabets for digits 10 to 15. So in hexadecimal number system, there are 16 digits, that is 0 to 15. We represent first 10 digits as 0 to 9, and the remaining 10 to 15 we use alphabets. For example, for 10 decimal number we use capital A, for 11 B, 12 C, and for 15 we use F. So remember these things. Now conversion from decimal to hexadecimal. So first we will learn how to convert decimal to hexadecimal. If you remember, I told you when one type is decimal, we will consider as a other as a binary. So whatever, if you have understood that decimal to binary and binary to decimal, you can do any conversion. Like in decimal to binary, what we used to do, we used to divide the decimal by 2, because the base of binary is 2. Now in case of decimal to hexa, we will again divide the decimal but by 16, because the base of hexadecimal is 16. So how will you convert 2699 to hexadecimal number? We will keep on dividing 2699 by 16 until you get 0 at the last. So you can write 0 over here. I have taken example from your book. If you write 0 over here, that is also correct. Without 0 also it is correct. So in decimal to binary we used to write 0, so you can write 0 over here. So keep on dividing 2699 by 16 until you get 0 at the last. Then how will you write the answer? Again, from the bottom to top. Now last digit you got 10, but you will always remember, you will not write 10. Instead of 10, what we will write? We will write A, because in hexadecimal we represent 10 by A. So 10 in bracket you will write A. Then 8 is correct, because 0 to 9 we write as it is, and 11 we represent by B. So answer will be not 10811, we will write A8B. Fine. So the required hexadecimal number is A8B. I hope this is clear. Now I am taking one more example to explain clearly. Conversion, again the same, decimal to hexa. I am taking another example, 58823. Fine. The procedure will be same. We will keep on dividing 58823 by 16 until you get 0 at the last. So if you divide 58823, for example, you divide and you get the remainder 7. So you will write remainder over here. Again, if you divide 3676 by 16, what will you get? You get the remainder 12. In bracket, you will write C. Fine, because you represent 12 by C. Again, you divide 229 by 16, you get 14 as a dividend and 5 as a remainder. Then here at the last you can write 160, or you can simply copy 14 over here, both will be correct. Fine. Now 14 you represent by E. So answer will be E5C7. Fine. So now it is clear, I have conversion from decimal to hexadecimal. Learn conversion from hexa to decimal. So again, as we did in binary to decimal, we will apply the same procedure, only one change will be there, and that will be the change of base. In binary to decimal, we used power 2^0, 2^1, but in hexadecimal to decimal, we will use 16^0, 16^1, and 16^2, and so on. Fine. So same procedure. First, we will write the hexadecimal number as it is, 7CE. This you can write at first place also, doesn't matter. Fine. Hexadecimal digit, you can write at first place, then power, then value, doesn't matter. So first you will write 7CE with some space, then you will write power 16^0, fine, start way from the right hand side, 16^1, then 16^2, then write the value of power, any number raised to power 0 is 1. 16^1 is 16, 16^2 is 256. Then the next step is to multiply hexadecimal by value. So multiply these two, 14 into 1, 14, 12 into 16, 192, and 7 into 256, you will get 1792. Fine. Then the required decimal number is, we will add these three values and you will get it 1998. So the procedure is exactly same as we did in binary to decimal. So the answer you will get it 1998. Only the difference is of what I just told you, only the difference is of this base. Instead of 2^0, 2^1, 2^2, we will write 16^0, 16^1, and 16^2. I hope it is clear. Now, okay, I am taking one more example. Conversion from hexadecimal to decimal. Fine. Again, I have taken a hexadecimal D5E. How will you convert? First, we will write that hexadecimal. Both ways are correct. Either you write the power at the first place or hexadecimal. Fine. So we will write hexadecimal first with some space, D5E. Fine. In bracket, we will write its value. For example, we represent, we use D for 13. We use E for 14. So we will write in bracket. Then we will write power 16^0 from the right hand side. We always start 16^0, 16^1, 16^2. Any number raised to power 0, 1, 16, 256. Sorry. Then we will multiply this hexadecimal 2 by value. So we will multiply 14 into 1, 14. 5 into 16, 80, 13 into 256, 3328, then we add these numbers and we will get the required decimal number. Fine. Now, next. So, till now, what we have discussed? We have discussed hexadecimal to decimal and decimal to hexadecimal. I hope both types are clear. Now moving ahead, we will learn hexadecimal to binary and binary to hexadecimal number. I hope you remember octal to binary and binary to octal. Very similar procedure of hexadecimal also, to convert hexa to binary and binary to binary to hexadecimal. So let's see. Now 1101 is equivalent of 13. From the table we will see 110 is equivalent of 12 and 0100 is equivalent of 4. Fine. Now instead of 12, we will write C and 13D. 4CD will be the required hexadecimal number. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now the next is binary to hexadecimal. Now, in binary to hexadecimal, again the same thing. This is the example from your book. As I told you, we will make the group of 4 bits. So let's make group of 4 bits. If you can see 0011. Fine. Now the next is 1101. Now the 2 bits are left. So what will you do? You will add 2 more zeros, like 0011. Fine. Now we will write these 3 groups here. Start from the right hand side, always remember, start from the right hand side. So first you will write 1100, then 1011, then 1001. So from the table we will see 1100 is equivalent of 12, 1011 11, 0011 is 3. Now 12 you represent by C, 11 B, and 3 you represent by 3 only. So answer will be 3BC. Fine students? Okay. Now moving ahead. Now we will learn hexadecimal to binary. To convert hexadecimal to binary, what we will do? We will write the hexadecimal. Fine. Now very simple. We will use the table. As we know, we represent A by 10, B by 11, C by 12. Fine. Now the direct, you can write the binary equivalent also. From table, if we see, C is equivalent of 1100, B is equivalent of 1011, and A is equivalent of 1010. From the table, you will write directly from the table, you can write. But if you have not drawn the table and if you write the answer directly, no marks will be given. So table should be there, one table at least. Fine. Only one table will be there, and that is hexadecimal. So today you will practice for this hexadecimal table. Fine. Now 1010 1011 1100, if you write these bits together, you will get the required binary number. Fine. Very simple. Directly we will use the table and write its equivalent binary. Table is now hexadecimal to binary is another example. First D97. So D is equivalent of 13. So you can write 1397, or you can write D97 directly. Fine. Then its equivalent, binary equivalent, you will write from the table. So this is the binary equivalent. And if you, when you write it together, you will get the required binary number. So today we discussed 4 conversions: decimal to hexa, hexa to decimal, then binary to hexa, and hexa to binary. Not difficult at all. Same procedure, only the differences of base. If you have understood the one type, you can do any other type. I hope you have understood this. You will practice all this, then only you will be more comfortable. Fine. So that's it. Now if now you can subscribe the channel to get the latest videos at first. Thank you so much. Thank you, students.